A family's grief made worse, knowing their loved one's tragic death could have been avoided. 22-year-old Danny Alcantara is one of two victims in the deadly crash Sunday night. And police say a drunk driver may be to blame. Good evening. I'm Rob McCartney.
And I'm Brandi Peterson. 24-year-old linker Manuel Santos Gomez also died in the crash. He was the passenger in the car that hit Alcantara.
Its driver, 27-year-old Victor Rodriguez, is booked in jail on two counts of criminal homicide. Police say he ran after the crash. KATV News Watch 7's Natalie Gluckwich is live. Natalie?
Rob, according to police, the suspect ran from the crash site to his home before he ran again when they were trying to arrest him. And even though that suspect is now behind bars, families of the victims say nothing can ease their pain.
Everybody knows that. Everybody's just devastated. Nobody can believe it still.
His name is still in his phone.
I don't know. I'm not going to erase him from my contacts.
But Michael Barriga says it's hard to believe his cousin, Danny Alcantara, is no longer in his life.
I don't know. It feels like a dream.
The 22-year-old former Burke student and nursing home assistant died Sunday night in this car crash on 42nd and H. His girlfriend was driving. She and three other passengers, a 7-year-old and two teenagers, were taken to the hospital but survived. Police say it started when this white SUV lost control and hit Alcantara's car head-on. Its passenger, 24-year-old linker Manuel Santos Gomez, died too. Police say its driver, 27-year-old Victor Rodriguez, may have been speeding, drinking, or both.
The thing that made me mad was that it wasn't even his fault. It could have been prevented.
Police say Rodriguez ran from the scene of the crash all the way from 42nd and H to his home on South 14th Street, where he was arrested. He's now booked on two counts of criminal homicide as two families grapple with their losses.
I mean, death is just something new to us. Nobody has actually really died from our family. He was a good kid.
Now, it is unknown if anyone in either vehicle wore seatbelts, and investigators are waiting for blood test results to come back. If Rodriguez did have alcohol in his system, he may be cited for DUI. The county attorney will likely change those charges. Back to you.
All right, Natalie Gluckwich, reporting live. Thank you.